Hey, this is Agent 355.
And I'm Yappo, and what the hell did you put on your screen?
It's Mulberic. She's so kawaii.
Oh, this is the worst.
It is the best worst. So this is the Gate of Illusion. The Gate of Illusion is, by and large, the first real stepping stone in the game. By which I mean, it's the first place where, even if you're taking nice dandy little careful notes and keeping track of all your stuff and, you know, reading all the tablets, you still might have trouble getting through this area because this area hates you.
It's a good quality for a game to have.
Yeah. The faces in the background, those big, they're like the big Olmec heads of the Gate of Guidance. The Gate of Illusion is the backside of the Gate of Guidance. And where the Gate of Guidance is supposed to be like your tutorial, your starting area, we're kind of walking you through it and keeping everything light and breezy, the Gate of Illusion is trying to trick you and mess you up. So the Olmec heads, instead of, you know, looking on fatherly, are instead laughing at you, which I think is great.
That seems a little harsh.
I think it's great. I think it's really nice world building that, you know, if you think about it, is like, oh, I see. But if you never really think about it, it's just, oh, I guess there's laughing heads in the background. So that's exactly what it is. Instead of looking on solemnly as you get your feet underneath you, they're mocking you relentlessly as you fail.
I do like the dragons with shield dudes.
So this is the first puzzle we really have. And this is, because the hardest puzzle in the game is, how do I turn Callgraph on? This is actually our second recording. But I'm still not sure Yappo actually remembers the solution to this puzzle.
I do, actually, believe it or not. I have slightly longer memory than a goldfish, but it's like 1.5 times.
Because I know I'm pretty sure often I ask you, hey, do you remember this from last episode? And you go, nope.
Well, to be fair, not only did you forget to record Callgraph, but we had to do it in 2 stints the first time, because...
Which I did record the first time. Okay, look, Raid Knight is important, okay?
Apparently.
So the tablet says something about idiots go to the right and other idiots went to the left. So that doesn't really give me many clues, so we're just going to kind of search and see what we can find here. So the going to the right kind of dead-ended. I mean, the only place we can go down here is into this little pit trap, which there's obviously nothing down there, unless you like money.
And dying slowly on spikes.
Yeah, well, you know, par for the course.
That's true. You were definitely keeping spike manufacturers in business, and spike repairmen.
Speaking of spike repairmen, actually, one of the things that another game out there did that I loved a lot, the game called Bard's Tale. You could break barrels in the game to, you know, sometimes get gold drops and stuff like that, but also there was a barrel manufacturer who would pay you money for breaking barrels.
That does really rule.
Yeah, that was really great. I love that game. So we ran out of weights. I fixed the problem. We now have 98 weights. But we'll still need more before the end of the game.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, you go through a lot of them. Especially because some areas with those one-way walls are basically just forcing you to use weights for no reason.
Well, the reason is to make you hate yourself in this game,
yeah,
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, so we tried right, so let's go left. Maybe left is the correct answer. I mean, assumably, both of them are going to be dead ends, but one of them maybe will contain, like, a puzzle or some trick that we can solve. I would guess.
A trick in La Mulana? You jest.
A thing that's not as it seems in an area called the Gate of Illusion? I can't imagine. So we can find a chest real easy behind that wall, but still not open, so what you going to do?
They need to have, like, a lockpicking set or something in here, so you can just, like...
They already
be like, no, I want this chest right now!
They already have an item for getting past things that are too hard, that you can't handle, and it's called the gun. Pew pew. But it only works on bosses and not puzzles.
Oh, that would be amazing. Like, yeah. You see a tablet with a puzzle, and you just, like, shoot it, and the puzzle breaks. You're like, yes, I solved it!
Okay, so... This area is going to teach you that you have to pay attention to the background a lot. You see that little blue light next to us?
The solid one?
Yeah, you see how it's not blinking, and how the two other ones in the room are blinking, and how every other one in the entire dungeon's blinking? This light is phony. You have to scan the light. and it solves the puzzle. No. Hooray. No, there are no clues that you have to do that except that the light isn't blinking. Get used to it. So now we solved the first puzzle.
I think it's a little hasty to call you wise one there, but maybe that's just me.
Well, I like how it's like, oh hey, no, it's not even like wise one. It's like, oh hey, you did good, son. Now step it up because we're not done yet. Hey, look, we opened those chests. Those open just by walking in front of all four of the other chests for some reason.
Just to make you backtrack.
I don't know. I don't quite know why they open. There's no tablet saying why. But it's not exactly like you can miss it. You have to walk in front of them, so who cares?
Yay, ladders. At least they get you back to it fairly quickly. Like, they take pity on you and don't make you backtrack through the whole thing.
Yeah.
So why are you skipping that chest?
Well, because again, you say, knowing full well why. Because the theme for this area is noticing when things are not normal. And normally those chests are glowing, so this chest is actually a bomb.
I would also like to note that I totally noticed that the first time we were watching through, so I am now a pro La Mulana player, FYI.
It's true. You basically solved all the puzzles as we went. It was actually very impressive, seeing how you weren't even playing the game.
That's actually a lie. That the only thing I figured out was the chest.
So
the whole left-right thing was just completely foreign to me.
So the left-right thing, we did it, but the only thing we got out of it was the map. Because if you look really closely at that wall in front of us, it's glowing ever so slightly. It's a teleporter. This is a teleporter maze.
I would also like to note that I noticed that. Just, you know, for reference.
I did not. I didn't even notice it after I saw after a guide pointed me out. I still have to run my face into walls to see it. So this is a big teleporter maze, and we have to figure out a way through it. If you take the wrong way, or you end up where you're not supposed to be, eventually it will spit you out somewhere where you can't get back into the maze. As I think I show off in just a second.
So do you ever use all these shurikens you collect, or you just, like, stockpile?
Shurikens are worthless. Okay, let me rephrase that. They're not worthless, but they're pretty close to worthless. The other weapons, especially some of the, especially the chakram, and some of the ones we don't have yet, are very, very good, and you should use heck of a lot. See that we just got spit out. But shurikens do 1 point of damage, where the axe does 3. So if I wanted to kill something that took an axe hit from far away, I would have to throw and hit with 3 shurikens.
And I guess considering your ability to play this game, that's probably asking a lot.
Yeah, I mean, they're great for taking out bats, because bats only have 1 HP. Okay, so here's the solution to this thing. If you try to play the teleporter game and, you know, map out where they all go and try to figure out the solution, you're just going to end up sad and disappointed, because the solution is don't play their game. This tablet says the courage to search on bended knee for a single fallen item. And again, half the part of this area is remembering how things are supposed to work, and when you break open a thing, it's supposed to drop 10 and not 1, and it's not supposed to drop it twice, so there's something special here. And you have to, on bended knee, or, you know, press down to teleport. And then, at this point, if you go to the left at all, you will fuck yourself and have to go around again. See? Told ya.
Pro skills.
So, I was just demonstrating that.
Clearly.
So, I mean, this is not really a trick, per se, but once you do actually figure out this part of the puzzle, and you get to the next area, just go right. Go right away.
See, to me, that's just another, like, fuck you thing they put in there. Like, oh, you're trying to teleport through? Let's make it even more ridiculously difficult.
Yeah, it's not like there's not other ones of those. Some games, like, really avoid the gotchas, and they want to make sure that everything is completely fair. This game doesn't. This game has gotchas. And they're being mocked by two heads. One of which is upside down, which just makes no sense whatsoever. One of the best NPCs in the game.
I do love the shopkeepers. I love fraud.
That clearly says I heart fraud.
If only it would have been I less than 3 fraud.
So this is actually a really cool puzzle. I really like this puzzle. Because he's kind of blatant about it. But it's not. Like, it's not blatant, but it is blatant. He tells you what you need to do. He says that he wants treasure, and that the fairies took it from him and made a big head hold on to it. But they said they swallowed it, and the big heads in here all have their mouth open. And when they say swallow, he really means to hide it in the mouth, right? He doesn't really mean he swallowed it. Because obviously big heads, big faces on the wall don't have throats.
You don't know that. You're not a big face archaeologist. Biologist, I don't know exactly which ologist that would be. But you're, whatever it is, you're not one.
I'm an ear, eye, and nose ophthalmologist or whatever. So the other big heads are located in the Gate of Guidance. If you remember, there aren't any other big heads in the game. And yet, if you go through the Gate of Guidance, what you find is every single one of them has either no mouth or a open mouth or something like that, except for one. Which I think is really clever. So there's no trial and error here. I mean, obviously, you could just go and see which head is... Just keep testing heads. But if you try to logic it through and say, well, hey, if their mouth is open, they probably aren't holding on to it. There's only one that actually fits the bill. And he's right here. Hey, dude.
He looks very unhappy to have been eating treasure.
Yeah, he looks like he's kind of got a grimace going. So we have to use the pepper. No, don't throw a shuriken at him. Use the pepper. No. Okay, well, that's not working. Well, how is Pepper gonna make a guy, you know, spit up what he's holding? Oh, that's right. Pepper makes you sneeze. Let's put it under his nose. Oh. Genius.
I do like that puzzle. That's a pretty fun, pretty straightforward puzzle, but you do have to do a little bit of thinking.
Yeah. And it's... And I want to say this is the introduction to the idea that the puzzle for the area you want to be in does not necessarily get solved in that area. It might send you halfway across the world to get what you need.
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's a good... This is a good, like, intro lesson on NPC quests in, like...
Yeah.
Crazy worlds.
Yeah, and, like, I mean, previously, hey, you know, if we have a problem with Spring in the Sky, well, the solution's probably in Spring in the Sky. I mean, maybe we need to go get a helmet from somewhere else, but once we have the helmet, all the solutions are in here. And now they're like, nope, sometimes we're going to give you a puzzle, and in order to advance further in this area, you have to leave, go to a completely different area, and come back.
I hate that. My OCD really just wants no part of that.
Yeah, no, it's going to be a recurring theme here, as the rest of the game. Which I really like. It's one of my favorite parts about the game. It's almost like, you know, you work... It's like you put trying to put a jigsaw puzzle together. And you start by putting the edge pieces together. And then halfway through putting the jigsaw together, you start finding pieces that obviously don't even fit in this puzzle. And you realize there's actually three jigsaw pieces in your puzzle box. Or three jigsaw puzzles, and all the pieces are messed together. And you realize everything's all wacky. And it really steps up the difficulty further than you think it was going to go.
I don't know where you're buying your puzzles, but you should probably have a chat with them about that.
Actually, that's actually a thing. There actually is things. Like, if you want, like, there's particular companies that sell the hardest jigsaw puzzles, and they're either double-sided, or they put two puzzles in one box. Like, for people who are really good at jigsaw puzzles, which might be me, I might have solved those. I love jigsaw puzzles. But yeah, they actually sell things like that. They're pretty great.
Nerd.
My favorite jigsaw puzzle was a 2,000-piece puzzle of nothing but sheet music. It was all white with little black lines and dots, and there was no way to tell where any of the pieces went. Like, it's just sheet music.
I've seen a jigsaw puzzle of the Beatles' White Album before.
Yeah, like, those are the hardest. Those are so difficult. Well, okay, they're not the hardest. There are harder ones than that, but those are really fun.
So back to the thing at hand. I see you have an anchor.
I do. It's just weighing me down. Get it? It was a joke. You can laugh.
I could. So I could also kill myself.
If we tried to go down this thing before, it wouldn't have let us because the water's flowing up and it would have pushed us to the surface. So that's the only reason we had to do the pepper thing. As far as I know, the anchor never... I take it back. The anchor totally comes into use again later. But at the point when the anchor comes into use... You would never have gotten there if you hadn't done this area anyway, so I guess it's not really in use. Here we're blocked off again. I love that you solve a puzzle, you get to go one screen further, and then they're like, oh, fuck you, another puzzle. You don't even feel like we didn't get off of this screen before we got stuck again. This one's kind of tricky.
So, did they implement smell-o-vision in La Mulana, or what other senses are we supposed to be relying on here?
Probably your sense of thinking. Because it told us to jump into the illusion. Oh gosh, there we go.
That's not a sense at all.
That totally is a sense. Puzzle sense. Game sense. Game sense was a word people use sometimes.
When? When was that a thing? Like, I'm pretty sure you're full of shit.
Dota esports. I just did Dota mostly. So now this guy, he gives us a thing.
And we have to prove that we're small.
Yeah. Now, that should sound familiar, like, thou art small, we've seen that on a tablet before. So we've already seen the solution to this one.
Wait, where's the page turn?
It's later. Also, I think I forgot to put it in. Yeah, I did. Also, and then again, there's a teleporter. So, okay, alright, let me explain something. I did this puzzle, and then I realized I didn't really show off what the solution was very well. And the thing is, this tablet on the left is actually a phony. If you push it, it will just drop you down, and you'll have to go through the maze again. The thing you have to notice here is that this skeleton passes in front of Lameza's sprite, which means it's something funny is about it. So you actually put the weight on the skeleton. Now, the other thing I have to mention is that while I meant to just replace my section of the game with this and show it off and then edit back to the regular game, or the regular run, I kinda forgot to delete the regular run, so now we're gonna get ready to solve the exact same puzzle again.
And you were giving me shit for my editing skills.
Your editing skills are awful, and you're also terrible at making OPs.
That's true. I'll give you that one. I'm basically lazy, so you know.
My OP is pretty lazy, I'm not gonna complain.
That's why commentary is the best. It's like somebody, I just send you a video, and then you fire up Skype, and you're like, oh, okay, this is all I have to do.
So now not only do we get to watch the same room over again, we get to watch it with slowdown, because all of a sudden, Fraps decided it didn't want to behave. So this is me not showing off the puzzle very well at all, and just running over and solving it, and running away again. Or, I should say, as soon as I get back in this room. I did the puzzle from memory, and I actually had to ask a friend of mine what the solution was, because I had to ask him why the solution was, because I'd completely forgotten, because I didn't even notice about the skeleton being in front of the sprite.
Shameful.
I know, right? And then I tried.
How?
Well, then I tried. I tried to be good, and I tried to go back and fix my mistake, and then I realized it didn't work. There we go. Good job, me.
How do you expect to law all the Mulanas that way if you can't even figure out these puzzles?
There are worse puzzles.
Exactly, that's my point, is you're going to get further along and be like, oh god!
To be fair, well, it does ramp up from here, and we are not done yet. It doesn't ramp up too hard. So this thing said, something about gotta push them all down before the one falls. This apparently was a really tricky puzzle in the original game, but is now nothing but a little race, which is really easy. I don't know. It's not even a puzzle.
It kind of is. I can, like, I don't know. It's more puzzly than some things.
Yeah. So, from this point, La Mulana definitely does get harder, but I would say probably the jump from before the Gate of Illusion to after the Gate of Illusion is the hardest jump there is.
This is some pro combat right here.
Kangaroo rats are tricky bastards.
I like that you chase him across the screen trying to kill him and then just give up. You're like, yeah,
I'm done. You win this round. You earned your freedom.
What a horrible adversary. So, I'm surprised they let you swing on ladders, because this seems like the kind of game that would just be like, nope, you can't do anything on ladders, but they're super necessary.
Good job, me. So what doing the little tablet race thing he did actually was open this ladder right next to me. We could have watched it come down, but the guy knocked me out of the room in the middle of the animation, so. Blame lizard dudes.
So I see a block, but I don't see anything on which to put the block.
Well, in this case, the block is not, you know, a way to push down a thing. It's a way to solve a puzzle, I guess you could say.
Oh, yeah, because that ladder's short.
Yeah. So we can't get up that ladder, and because Lameza is completely incapable of jumping up and grabbing a ladder... I mean, I can't judge too harshly.
I was going to say, could you jump up and grab a ladder?
I probably could not do that either. So yeah.
Then again, you're not Kawhi Indiana Jones.
I'm not Kawhi. I mean, yeah, like, if I had that hat, I probably could do it.
But you're a goon, so all you have to have is a fedora.
So this is going to be upcoming is an incredibly impressive display of video gamesmanship.
Oh god. I forgot.
Okay, so there's this wall with this fairy on the left up here. We're not going to have long to see it, so I'm talking about it now. And the game decides to slow down again. This wall can only be broken from the right side, which means I have to break it from the elevator, and you don't have much time to do it. So I'm trying to break it on my way up.
And so instead you just jump off the elevator.
Well, I was trying to get really close to the edge, because you have to be very close to the edge. And I done fucked up, son.
There. It's horrible.
There we go. This is probably close enough. So I'm just going to swing as it goes up and break the sucker. Uh-oh. I need one more hit. So bombs away. And I tried to be very fancy and after hitting it once, jump back up onto the elevator, but it didn't work.
I do like that it had the little like fairy insignia on it. So it's like, hey, look right here. Hey.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, there's something here.
I would laugh really hard if that was one of the ones that respawned on screen transition.
That'd be awful.
That would be amazing. Test out those pro platforming skills.
Yeah. Sure, a lot of upside down heads around. I wonder why.
Because we're in... Yeah, it's true.
Darn it.
Well, that one almost just makes visual sense as far as like the elevator connected thing, but...
Yeah.
Is there a puzzle involving upside-down heads?
Maybe.
Because so far, I think we've only seen one room that has both an upside-down and a regular head.
Yeah, there's a handful of them.
Oh, are there?
Yeah, there's a handful of them. But the thing is, like, I don't know. Maybe. It just seems a little out of place to me. But...
Yay, more gibberish.
Another gibberish one. Now... The reason they're gibberish, I guess, is because they're written in a different language than the translator software we have uses. And we can actually decode that language, but we basically have to find someone to help us do that. We can't do it by ourselves.
Is it some sort of crazy cipher, or did people actually like go through and decipher it?
No,
before
no, it's an in-game thing. It's not just a crazy, you know, out-of-game, you know, incredibly nerdy autistic people thing.
Because that seems like something this game would do, give you some, like, serious hints and, like, some crazy cipher.
There are a number of language-based puzzles in the game that involve this, that, or the other thing, and they're all very cleverly done, so have no fear. I should have stayed on that ladder. I should have stayed.
It's a fairy.
Yeah, it is a fairy. So, here's another one of those games that you can get. I can't afford it, though.
Lonely House Moving?
I don't know. I got nothing.
That's supposed to be a knockoff of.
Well, these are all games that Dude made.
Oh.
They're not, like, knockoff of other games. They're games that this company has made. Or maybe just people in the company. I don't know. I think it's the company itself.
I'm really surprised that this section takes such pity on you with the exit and retry, like, right there.
Yeah, I don't really know what the point of that one-way door is, actually. I think, I mean, all, other than to make you try to jump down through the middle.
It's a good fairy pull there, since you were down to 9 health.
Yeah, to be fair, you have like an 80% chance of getting a healing fairy. So, there's nothing to tell you that this there's a broken floor here, but there's a breakable floor here. Actually, when I say that there's nothing, that's a lie. There's something later in the level that we'll see. I just broke it now because I didn't want to come back.
It's a fairy gate.
Yeah, more fairies. And I hate these lizard dudes. They're awful. They have shields. They shoot fire.
They smack you in the face with a sword.
I mean, like, I have a silver shield. If I equipped mine, the fire would be a lot more manageable, but that would, you know, be intelligent, so I'm not going to do that.
Good call.
I don't want to, you know, shake up anything at this point.
Well, you know, we got to save some stuff for Olesh at least.
Yeah. So it says the fairies unlock it. It's obviously not the healing fairy, because she ain't doing crap. But
so we got to go grind for fairies?
Kind of. If you recall, which I know you don't, back in the Spring in the Sky, there was actually a tablet that told us that there were four different types of fairies. Mm-hmm. Now, we've seen the weapon fairy before. We've seen the healing fairy before. We saw her just now. We've seen the fairy that makes you drop stuff from pots and enemies. But we haven't seen the fourth fairy, and the fourth fairy is the key fairy, which obviously opens the thing. So all we have to do is we have to come back here with the key fairy to get into there. Which I could do right now, but because Olesh is under constraints to not fight anything until I, or not get anything before I get it, you know, because it's a self-imposed constraint, I'm not going to get it until after I beat the next boss, because,
because you're a huge dick.
Because I'm a dick, basically. That's, yeah, what's going on. Also, also confusing to me is why that button didn't seem to open the way to the save gate. There's the laser there. I don't know.
Something. Well, there's that yellow square there in the background.
Yeah, let me go scan that in just a second, because it obviously looks like something. I don't know.
How do we break it?
I don't know. Something's going on in this room.
Some chicanery right there.
Luckily, what the button did do is make this hole. So, the laser's still there, but hey, that works.
I do kind of like that it gets you there, but it makes you, like, freak out before you realize it. You're like, oh god, what did that do? And I need the save point.
If I remember correctly, there's actually a reason for that, too. Like, there's something we'll see later, but... So here, it tells us that we have to be small, and here I'm going to hit myself with lightning a lot. So, we had that the small doll, and it says, like, you have to be tiny to proceed. It's got the same symbol on the wall here as it did outside that guy's home, so... Obviously, we have to solve that part of the puzzle now. This is actually fairly easy. There was a... God damn it. I knew I was going to do it, and I'm still disappointed that I did it. That's me forgetting what button uses items. I don't know. Twice. Just don't think about it too hard.
What about the parachuting ghosts? Can I think about them?
We'll talk about them when we come back.
Although, I guess that's actually closer to base jumping, but...
Yeah. So, there was a tablet in the Mausoleum of the Giants that said, like, you know, the mother was big compared to her, the giants were small. You are small compared to... You are truly small, or something like that. So what we have to do is we have to use the mini doll when we're next to one of the giants. And they'll be like, hey, yeah, you're totally tiny. That's the puzzle. It's pretty cool. I like it.
Seems like kind of a silly puzzle.
It is a very silly puzzle, but I like it. So now that we've done that, all we have to do is scan this tablet, and because I'm just a giant dumbass, all we gotta
get yourself lightning bolt a few more times, you know, just for good measure.
It hasn't happened enough. You asked me what shurikens are good for. Apparently, fucking hitting things on accident,
getting yourself killed.
So there. So we solved that. I think that's really cool. Again, it's one of those things where if you were keeping track of notes and you remembered, then it's really obvious. And if you weren't, well, good luck. Because you should have been.
That thing looks like it's going to fuck you up.
Yeah, this guy's not nice. So those ghost ladies, we've seen them walking through the halls before. But apparently they're throwing themselves down this sacrificial pit. And all of their ghost juice is dripping to this thing in the... Ugh, that's gross, right? And the blood drops from the ceiling seem to be healing him. At least, you know, in video games, green is healing, right? So... I'm assuming that's healing him.
I kind of want to see Olesh, like, just be like, fuck it, and go just kill him anyway, because he can do it fast enough.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Just to prove you wrong.
I'm pretty sure it's impossible. But, so we have to close that sacrificial pit before we can do anything. And instead what we're going to see is a bit of more platforming prowess from me.
So this room looks good, and right up your alley, too.
I'm not that bad at platforming, although I will admit I do not put on a very good show in this game. I'm really...
You say that, but all of the video evidence you've posted online indicates otherwise.
Hey, I have 100% Super Meat Boy. I think that says enough. But, yeah, so that's a trap. And a dick move. Which the game, I mean, you could say once you know it exists there that it's really a air quotes shortcut, but no, it's just a dick move. Off to this side, we can see where the lady... Oh, go back. Okay. We can see where the ladies spawn and where they throw themselves down the pit from that little brazier over there. Looks like if we were very careful about our jump, we could totally get over there too. But I think first I want to go over here.
But that's... I wouldn't trust you to be very careful with your jump.
I don't know why you say that. So then we're back...
Just to hurt your feelings.
I love this line. This is great. I just pat on the back. That's... I couldn't beat the game, but I got through the Gate of Illusion. So pat me on the back, guy.
I feel like you should be able to like hit him with a weapon on the back. And like have him like spawn a gold coin or something.
Yeah.
Just something silly, like for you to actually pat him on the back.
So for having gone through the Gate of Illusion and come out in the Gate of Guidance through the backside door, you get access to that little the floor switch, which will allow us to deactivate this trap and actually get to the treasure chest. Which, if you remember, we actually saw in like the first or second video, but could not actually open.
Ooh, software.
Yeah. It's a Google Map ripoff.
I think it's a Yahoo Maps ripoff, yeah, but clearly.
Is Yahoo Apps even a thing?
I thought it was.
I don't know. Maybe it is.
I thought everyone had a map app for a while there. Ooh, that's fancy.
Yeah, so what it does now is it shows it's not necessary, I mean it doesn't actually help you do anything, but it does keep track of everything and shows you all of the rooms, and it shows you where you can get to different zones. You see it's marking off where you can get Spring the Sky and Tumble the Sun and all that jazz. So it's pretty cool.
It's more Binding of Isaac-y now, which is always better.
And more importantly, what it's going to do for us is when we get back to the other zone, all of those secret rooms that we found, like the one with the axe in it and the one with the fairy puzzle, they show up now. So when I actually get around to opening the map, there we go. Those pink rooms are secret rooms.
Fancy.
So that's how even if obviously if you knew there was a breakable floor there, you could still break it without having the hint. But now you would know to look. So let's do some sick jumps. Nailed it. You should probably teleport out. Oh, never mind. Okay.
I really wish like they would have made those like specifically like insta-death.
No Mega Man spikes in this game, I'm sorry.
Just so you could be sacrificed to the thing that's gonna knock your shit in later.
No, I thought about going up there and trying for the sweet jump again, but I decided I would rather close the pit first. And there's a teleport here. And then more things we can't read.
With a little pictograph of somebody worshipping a big crazy thing.
Yeah, now to get into the room below us is a secret trapdoor over here. And if you did not have I think that's the birth seal. If you did not have the birth seal yet, or the death seal, or whichever one that is, you would not be able to beat the next boss. Because technically, you could have come here before Spring in the Sky. Technically, there's no reason you couldn't have.
Also, apparently your trapdoor did nothing because the ghosts just fall through it.
Yeah, that's a graphical glitch. What it actually is that a ghost spawned in the room above us, but pushing this button will make them stop spawning, right? However, if one is already spawned, she will still jump off and dive and stuff, but... So, that's kind of how that works.
I like that instead of actually making them fall and just, like, mill around the level, they just, like, nope, they turn off now.
Yeah, no, yeah, they just stop spawning. You see there's no fire. And there's a sweet jump. So, why can I get up here? There must be some reason.
Hacks.
There we go. And, I don't know, maybe... I don't know why that exists. Like, I don't know.
To give him a cool mustache, I guess?
That's probably the best thing I can think of. Something's going on here, but I don't really know what.
That's all I've got.
So, we've done pretty much everything in the spring in here that we can. So let's go and kill the giant six-armed bull man.
It's only six?
It's six, yeah. Mm. One holds the axe, one holds the shield, three in the back are empty, but they throw the projectiles, and one in the front is empty, and I don't know why it exists.
In case you get too close, it can just punch you.
Could be.
I feel like that's a thing giant mutated centaurs would do.
I was so confused by this thing. I came up here and looked around.
Or no, minotaurs.
Yeah. I feel like it's got to do something, right? But I don't remember what. Other than get it being held up by two statues that kind of look like Deadpool?
I think you're stretching a bit there.
I don't know. I mean, they got the big black eye thing going on.
Racist.
So let's go back to the surface and get some HPs and then go fight the boss man.
Are we gonna leave it in? Are we gonna have some sweet? Only a little bit.
I have a deal with my friend that if I ever forget to edit in a town trip, or edit out a town trip, that I have to replace its music with something else. So I'm hoping that doesn't happen because I'm afraid of copyright laws. This is not a boss. This is a mini boss. The bosses spawn donks. Mini bosses are just there. He's kind of tricky, actually. You have to, if you jump, his weak spot's his head, like, you know, many other bosses. But if you just try to jump up and hit his head straight away, good dodge. He will block it with a shield. But if you keep hitting a shield a few times, you can stun him, sort of like some of the other enemies with shields. And then in that stun is when your opening is. But of course, you have to get really close to hit his head, and then he charges at you, and it's really obnoxious.
I do like that his entire body is completely static except for the codpiece thing, which just, like, bounces around anytime he jumps.
I like that. I like that you were so entranced by his codpiece, you had to mention it in the re-recording.
Yeah, because it's funny as shit.
Yeah.
Again, I'm like 12, all
yeah,
right?
I know. It's great. It's really good.
Yeah. Anytime there's a fart joke, I'll be on top of that, too, so, you know.
So this is the guy I want Olish to fight without the item that the fairies give us. Which is just a little vindictive of me, I suppose. But I also didn't feel like going and getting it on camera, because it would have been awful. So, hey, look, the chest opened up. We should go run over there and grab it. Go on. Why are you waiting? Oh. Dick move, game. And yes, that will kill you, and yes, you will have to fight the boss over.
That's just a terrible gacha. Like,
I know. It's great.
Gachas that make you, like, replay stuff. Or, like, and there's no visual indication that that's going to fall.
None.
Like, the exploding chest, you can at least be like, okay, that one's not lit up.
None. It's just the game hates you. That's it. So we got the, this is... I don't want to go
in. This looks scary. Go away.
We're going to open up the shortcut and then leave, because holy crap. And we got the Endless Key, which tablets have told us is the key to the Endless Corridor, so maybe we can go there next. Probably not.